Hello everyone, welcome. So it has been a long time since I have posted a tutorial or complete workflow, and here is we can continue our series about product visualization or product modeling. So this may be quick video, not tip or a trick. So in this video I'm going to make a product which is sensors from Jaguar, and let's see some reference images from here. Here is some images I have found from an artist in ArtStation, and we will model these sensors. And here is the images from the top, and let's import this one. And we will import another one also, which is these dimensions. And before that, let's enable the screencast case. And I think that work. So we have here the length is 15 centimeter. So modeling scissors isn't hard, it's very simple. So we can start from a plane. Firstly, I will move this reference in the bottom like this, and after that maybe decrease some opacity 0.5, and after that's fine. I will here go to the design collection, because we have here the reference, and of course we will add camera collection later when you render. So I will add a plane. We will not work on dimensions now, but after making the whole product we can scale that to be 15 centimeters. So let's go here, we can scale, select all and scale, and put the plane here and some edge here and this one here. So this one here, and let's extrude such as this, and another time here, another time here, another time here. Let's extrude and let's fill. And here we can have another point here, and I will fill all these places. Before we get started, I will enable some add-ons. So we must have all these add-ons. So I will enable the loop tools, and after that I will enable F2 and maybe node wrangler later, so we can use in the materials or the shader editor. And that's it for now. You can enable extra objects or for mesh or curve. There's a lot of add-ons, but that is the most useful, F2 and loop tools. Of course they are free. And here is also another add-on which is I'm using, which is free, which is set flow. This is very helpful. Let me discuss what that make. So if you have this edge and you are making some curvy objects such as this, so if you go here and set flow, so it calculate the curve correctly such as this, so it calculate the curve correctly. So it make it smooth curve, so it make the curve smooth between all of these parties. So that's it for the set flow. It's very very helpful. And for something such as this, it's become very handy. As you can see, this is very very helpful add-on. So let's come back here and we can now continue, and I will make something. I will extrude here, extrude here, extrude here, extrude another time here, another time here, another time here. Let me extrude all of that. That's fine. I'm extruding. Let me fill, and here it will be a circle, and let's calculate all of these points. Maybe here we have, let's say 12. So I will put the cursor here and add a circle. Maybe here it will be 12, and let's scale down. And scale on the X, rotate, move here, scale on the X, local, and that's it. Maybe rotate some little bit such as this, and we can select two of this and full and fill, and let's see now, fill. And what else we can fill, of course. And here we have three, so we can fill now, fill, and maybe add loop cut here, and fill now, fill all of that. That's fine. What else? I will fill that and control W tab to subdivide. And for subdivide, it has no shortcut, but you can assign shortcut, which is Control W. What else? We can also here add loop cut, and I fill here and fill here. So making scissors or modeling this isn't hard at all. And of course we will add hole later, and let's see. Here we have a hole, and we can now add the bolts. I will bevel that little bit, and then I will delete this face. And we can go here to add circle. So this is the usage of this add-on. We have here an circle. We can add support loop. That's fine. We can now refine the curve a little bit. And here we are. And let's add the circle. Or scale a little bit. So that's fine. Let's see here. Let's see. And I will duplicate that and move to the base collection. And hide this collection. Then we can add here and thickness. Little bit, and remove this one, add another thickness, let's say 0.010 maybe, and here, right, here we can move that, and that here has some thickness, so I will select all these points, and we can select all these three faces and rotate around the x-axis, such as this. Rotate around the X, but this one will be the same here. That's fine. Let's see if we have added. And of course, here in the bottom, we have it to be scaled down, scaled such as this. And we can now select set flow. And let's see again. Also, the top is simple. All the top has some bevel, so we can scale that little bit. Scale that little bit. Let's scale. Maybe add support loop. And scale on the X. As you can see, this may be seems like a live session because I didn't record that before, and I will not edit this video. I will not edit or make any video editing, so you can consider this as a live session. Feel free to watch it at 1.5 speed. No problem at all. And maybe we can shift all these points on the Y, maybe such as this. And now it's the time to add the most helpful tool. All these notches can be solved by shift N, and of course we can slide little bit and slide all of these little bit, and set flow. Amazing. We can go here and add loop cut here, another loop cut here. That's fine. So let's see. We have here 1, 2. What here? Why we have here a triangle? This is strange. This is strange. No problem, we can solve that later. And I think we can merge this both M at center. Let's see. There is something. No problem. Anyway. We have here the circle, and here we should have the sharp. Let's see. and here we can shift that in the x-axis such as this. That's fine, and I think we can add loop cut here. Right, so once you have made this, we can, let's see, we can here smooth vertex and here also we can smooth vertex. Also here to make that even space. And it will be nice, and this may be a good start. And after that, we will duplicate that. So maybe I will move to the design collection and name this one server that F2 to rename this one to B1, and I will duplicate. Maybe I will put the cursor to be here. The cursor to be here and duplicate, rotate around the Z. Let's rotate around the Y. Amazing, amazing. Let's rotate around the Y, and as we have here, we have here to rotate around the Z also. And after that, let's move and this to be the same such as this. I think now we are perfect for that, but we have here to add some. So I will select, really I don't know why this is triangle, so but I merge at last. It's amazing. So I will select all of these parties, select all like this, and that's fine, that's fine. I will select also all of that. Let's see, maybe selecting, so I have selected all of that and extrude little bit, maybe to this distance, and after that I will slide 3 to this distance, and put edge here and another edge here. This is fine, this is fine. Alright, so here is the modeling part. And we have a little bit of notch here. This can be done. We have notch here. That can be done by extruding that. We can add a cube here and scale Z Control B Control B. Maybe such as this, and copy to selected. That's fine. And for this part, it's very simple. Put here the cursor and add a circle. This circle may be 24, and we have here a circle. Rotate. After scaling, I will rotate around y 90 degrees and put the cursor hand and rotate, scale. So we can extrude and scale. And maybe here. So let's first do something. I will bridge maybe 3, let's say maybe 4. So select all of that and edge bridge edge loop. What happens here? Bridge edge loop. And we have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's add 5 loop cuts and fill this area and fill this area. Select both of these faces in here, and you can now extrude like this. And you can rotate such as this, rotate, same thing here, you can select all and rotate around the active element, so you can use the active element or the let's rotate around the Z. That's fine. And what happened here? So I think let's come back. And put the cursor here, and using the cursor, select all of these vertex, rotate around the Z, and rotate around the Z. What's happening here? Also. That's fine. This is a little bit of detail that you can avoid, but we want it to be similar or perfect to the original, and it's extrude such as this. I'll put another loop cuts here. Of course, this is hyperbole, and if you want to make it ready for game engine, so you can reduce a lot of vertex, but no problem for us because we will not use for games. And here you can make a bolt. So I will add a new sphere maybe here 24 and a little bit of 0.0 maybe, and I will put here, and let's move to be here, and I will delete all these parts, and let's extrude scale, extrude scale, let's extrude in the Z, let's extrude in the Z, let's move here, and let's scale. We'll move to be here, control 2, move to be here, extrude scale, extrude scale, and fill. This is one part. And I want that to be in the bottom part. Also in the top part we have similar, we have one which is similar. Okay, I will say it will be 24 and scale. And extrude scale. And maybe here we can fill. And here we can fill. And we can fill all these parts. And here 1, 2, 3 we can add here 3 and fill that, and fill that. We can select all of vertices and move here, so we can extrude and select. I think we can select, what happens here, I will select all of these 4. And now we are ready. Let's add loop cut. And I'll move to be here. That's the little bit of detail, and here we are. And maybe RXX RYY RZZ, so we can rotate that in the Z axis to be straight, such as this, and let's rotate around the X in the active. I want it to be look like a sphere, maybe scale on Y, maybe such as this. Same thing here, rotate around the X, and scale on the Y, amazing. So we have done the modeling. What do you think? Amazing. So next, in around the 30 minutes we have finished the modeling. It's a little bit too much, but we have added any tiny detail as you can see. For this part here, we can select this part and set flow, and this part, and this part, and set flow, Amazing. Sonic is to we will add the materials.